Welcome to another great card basic demonstration. Today I'm going to take you through the Nextion GLCD device. Let's have a quick look at it to start with. Look, this is the display. It's a serially attached display. There's a pointy end. There's a ground. There's a 5 volts and a serial in, serial out device. And it's touch. Look, it's not touch. It has touch built in, and it has logic. Okay, so it has logic built in, so you can, it has a programmer which I'll show you in a moment, and you can load in these different pages, and there's logic built into it. Okay, so what we're going to do is control that from Great Card Basic. What does that editor look like? Here's an example. I've been playing with this, and actually this is in the demo. You've got an editor. This is the basic screen I'm showing you now, and I've got some text across the top called and then there's a screenshot I've taken and a little logo. And this is the editor that you use, and then you serially send that down to the device, and you can send many different screens. So if we have a look at the standard demonstration from the provider, you will find that it has a number of different screens in there, and that those screens relate to exactly what we were seeing a moment ago on the camera. So these screens, they're called pages. You can select them, and text and buttons. There we go. There's a zoom in, and all this is all this can be controlled via the touch screen, but also down the serial line. And that's what we're going to be using, the serial line. And so you need to have this editor that's behind here. You need to be able to pull in the default demonstrations, and I've given you the URLs to those. And so what you have to do is open up those demonstrations. They come with different files, a font file and a HMI file, and load that up. And essentially, the basic thing you need to get Great Card Basic working is a number of fonts. You need some fonts, because we're going to use the high-speed font. So what we're going to be using is all that capability that comes in the stock demos. Plus, we can use Great Card Basic to interface with it as well over the serial line. So let's have a look how that works. I'm going to bring in Great Card Basic, and I'm just going to bring up some demonstrations. So this is a demonstration for controlling the gauges, okay? And if we look back at the screen here, I've got a set of gauges in here on page 5. See if I can select them. There we go. And I've got a pot attached to it, and this pot up here is currently doing nothing because it's not programmed. The pick is not programmed, so I'm going to program that pick, and we'll come back to that in a moment. Let me just do that so we can see both things happening at the same time. So it's going to program that. It's just assembling that, and now it's copying that to the board. And as you can see in the background, it's taken me directly to the gauges screen. Now, how it's done that is that in Great Card Basic, we're able to select the screens. We can talk directly over the serial line to the display here. And so if I change the pot here, I can then send the pot. Now, my pot is jumping. I have to replace the pot here. But you can see that that is doing its stuff, apart from my little jumpiness of my pot here, which I need to replace. So I'm sending it some commands, and how I'm doing that is essentially loading up the Nextion driver in GLCD. I'm telling it the size of the screen. Now, there's lots of different screen sizes I've got here. I've got quite a few. Look, a much bigger one here. So I've got quite a few, and you can change the parameters. It goes up to 800 pixels wide. You must specify the baud rate, and that's always 9600, but you can use software. You can use software serial if you wish. If you read the documentation, it shows you how to do that. And then I'm basically saying to it, send it an instruction when it's okay, send me to the gauges page. So page select, but I'm doing a read the, I'm reading the ADC, and then I'm scaling that value as a new command in Great Card Basic at the moment. It will be out in April 2018, and then I'm telling it to update the objects, and they're called, this object is called Z1, this is called Z2, and this one is called T0, and they come from the editor themselves. So if I open up the stock demonstration, we can see that those objects exist in the editor and they've been downloaded via the serial line to the display, so I'm just sending it a few commands. In actual fact, all I'm sending it over the serial line is z0.val, and then this a string made up of the parameters that I need to send it in terms to update it. So if I look at another demo in here, this is going to demonstrate what, let's have a look. Oh, we're going to use, I'm going to compile this up and we'll see what it does. This is going to compile up and show us the stock Great Card Basic demonstration, and we're going to use the fonts that are built into it. So remember, the editor allows us to put pictures and these pages in there. I showed you that one that I'd made up earlier, and so it has some fonts. So how do we access those? We send it some commands, but there's the standard commands in Great Card Basic. So you just print a string to the graphics device and it will put it in the place where you want it. Now it's just programming it. There we go. So I've now changed the program. So I've got this font here, and this font here is all coming from Great Card Basic. All the circle commands are stock Great Card Basic commands. So what you have got is you've got some specialist strings. I've done that for a particular reason. I'll show you why in a moment. Okay, so this is print to the Nextion, and this is set the font type, and then the rest of it, or everything in blue here, as you can see, is pretty standard. So I've tried to keep this as standard as possible, and there's a reason for that, because you can still use the Great Card Basic fonts if you wish. So if I come to another demonstration in here, I'll load this one in. So what you've got is a set of extended commands for controlling and specifying the fonts. You can change the colors of the fonts on the fly. You've still got the same XY positioning, and you've got all the graphic control that you have in standard Great Card Basic. Now what is interesting is what it's now doing is compiling up to use the Great Card Basic fonts, and this is tremendously slow. And why is it slow? Because it's going to send, for each character, it's going to send 16 bits, 64 bits, and it is incredibly slow, as you can see. But it works, and it works because Great Card Basic has a common layer in terms of its font set. It has a common layer in terms of the open language, and that allows us to actually put the pixels out to sit on this serial device. Okay, keep going, because I know that don't take too long. This screen is a touch screen. Okay, so if I touch it, an event is raised, and that event is then passed down through the serial line. What I'm going to do now in this demonstration is very quickly show you that you can raise those events, capture it, and then show it on the screen. It's very simple. It's just loading it in now. There we go. I have reached somewhere. I've erased all the other objects. I've kept this one on there, and I've done that in the language lot. I can just do that in here. It's a bit of an extension to Great Card Basic. It's send an instruction to the Nextion. And this one here is actually called Visibility Viz, and it turns everything off. Then I just turn back on my one object I want to have showing, which is this value here. And if I touch the screen, I get a screen event. That is quite clever. So if I go back to my gauges, I can load my gauges back in there very quickly. This is a later version of Great Card Basic, and it's equivalent to version 0.9802. It's a lot faster, as you can see. That's already programmed that. And now I'm back in my gauges demonstration. So in here, I've got my gauges. So I wanted to show you, I must fix my pot. I wanted to show you Great Card Basic Nextion GLCD. That was the basic one, and you can drop off if you want to see how it's programmed. Stay with me. So how does it all work? Okay, well, it's pretty simple, to be quite honest. Okay, it's pretty simple. If you want to set this up, you need a couple of things to be be fixed to be running, you need to have the editor, and you need to have three fonts as a minimum inside of that to get some of the fonts working. It doesn't have to be the three that I've chosen. You can load in any fonts, and they're called fonts, and you're going to specify that configuration. So if I look at a full demonstration, this one here for instance, all you need to do is set up the GLCD here, and then you tell it it's a Nextion. You need to specify the width and the height of the device. I've made that parametric so that it supports all the Nextion devices. And then you need to tell it which fonts you're going to be using. Now these are the default sets, so there's a parameter in here and I'll show you where those come from. They're essentially the font numbers and the sizes. The font number 012 and the size of 8x16, 12x24. We just need to know that so that when we locate the font, we can locate it on the right point of the screen for you. And where do we get that from? We get that from this dialog screen inside of the Nextion editor. Next, you must set up the serial port. If you're using PPS, you just need to set up PPS, and you can optionally put these two commands in here. They're optional because they're already it's defaulting to hardware, but I've given you examples of how to set up serial as well. So if you want to do serial, that's easily done. Finally, you've got PPS there, and that is it set up. So in recap, what do you need to do? You need to include GLCD, specify the Nextion as a type. You need to tell it what size it is, the fonts, and then set up your serial. And then everything falls into place. Stock commands for everything, wherever I can, right? So, you know, when you've got this, when you want to draw something, like the graphical stuff, that is absolutely standard. Okay, that's all being handled. When you want to put some, when you want to do GLCD print, you just have to put underscore Nextion behind it, okay? And even default font is the same, underscore Nextion. So it's absolutely bog standard. I'm just messing that code up there. Okay, so that was a flyby of Great Car Basic and the Nextion GLCD. Let's call that a wrap.